Welcome to Wolverine TV with world champion Jonathan Field as he motivates and inspires you to become a champion of life. Sharing training tips, health and nutrition, and interviews with students, world champions, and other people you should know.
Here. All right. So, middle. both hands to an equal level of pressure. Generally, they will travel the same distance from point A to point B, they'll generate the exact same amount of power. Your chamber hand, your blow-up hand, will generate the exact same amount of power as you're doing
And stop hold here. Right, so if I can get you to go along the edge, because you'll be able to see the distance from here to here.
I think the main benefits are increased fitness and coordination, but also the mental aspect of taking a class like this with regards to an increase in focus, having to memorize punches, kicks, blocks, and patterns. Most definitely the enthusiasm the students display every class makes it really enjoyable. Also the amount of improvement I've seen in all the students since we started this is really quite remarkable. The main thing is that this class is run like any other class we have here at Coburg Taekwondo. I expect my students to always try their best, be respectful of others, and always have fun while learning a new skill.
Alright, today I just want to go through a general outline of your nutrition. So I can go through different things. Calories, obviously, how many calories you put in your body will affect the outcome of your nutrition plan. Whether you're trying to lose weight, gain weight, maintain weight, and whether you're an athletic first or not, it's going to dictate how many calories you put in your system per day, per week, per month, etc. So you need to figure out what your goal is so that you can manage your calories. Number two, macronutrition. As we've been discussing for the last 5 weeks, you need to know how different macros are going to affect your body, the different ratios. So we discussed that over the last 5 weeks. We can go back to the previous episode and look at the sections on macro nutrition. The third part of nutrition is to eat healthy. We're talking like 90-95% of the time. It's really hard to eat 100% healthy all the time. So, you know, eating 90-95% healthy. When I think healthy food, I think of food that a caveman would eat, or foods that our great-grandparents or great-great-grandparents would recognize as food. Basically, all the food that you see on the perimeter of the grocery store, not the food that's in the aisle that's packaged or boxed. The same with healthy beverages. Think of drinks that you know, a caveman would drink, or drinks that your great-great-grandparents would recognize. Not stuff that we wouldn't associate, like pops, carbonated drinks, stuff like that. Like supplements. Whether you need to take supplements or not, based on your goal. You don't have to take supplements. If you are following the rest of this, supplement is only really like the last 5% of the overall nutrition, so it's really not that important, unless you are not taking care of me, and you might have to supplement certain things, like certain vitamins or certain minerals that you're not getting within your regular food. Supplement can do that way. If you're an athlete, you require more. Non-athlete, require less. If you have certain health issues, certain supplements are going to help you with that. But number one important thing on your nutrition and what you're intaking, can you live on this forever? So is it a short-term diet or a long-term diet? I don't even like the word diet, I like nutrition plan. You need to be able to follow something, some kind of plan, your nutrition, that you can live on this point until the day you die. You don't want to keep going on a fat diet this week, this type of diet next week, 2 weeks from now when I go on a dinner diet. You need to maintain a nutrition plan that you can live on, and it's not going to drive you crazy.